Dear student, in this video I am going to talk about a very important chapter called electrolysis. So in this video I am going to talk about what is electrolysis, what do you mean by electrodes, and what is the process of electrolysis. So in the electrolysis, what basically happens? So let's talk about a step by step process. So electrolysis, so lysis means basically breakdown. Okay, whenever you heard this term lysis, it means breakdown. Okay, you will also learn this term, you know, in the biology also, that cell lysis means breakdown of the cells. So here what is breaking down? Here a solution is breaking down with help of electricity. So that's why this is called electrolysis. Electrolysis is a process of decomposing. Decomposing means basically breaking down of what? Ionic compound. Okay, breaking down of ionic compound into their element by passing a direct current, DC current, through the compound in a fluid form, which is called electrolyte. So in a simplified version, what you can write, you can also say that electrolysis is a process during which electricity is used. So here what happened? Electricity is used to break down, or you can say decompose, right, a compound. Mainly you will put ionic compound because that is the thing they will form ions, and it will be help to produce electricity in the electrolyte itself. A compound, or usually any compound, we said in the which state? In the molten or aqueous solution. So I hope this part is clear for you, that electrolysis is a process where electricity is used, okay, to see some chemical effect. Okay, and this is called, and in the part where the electrolysis takes place, that is called electrolytic cell. Okay, so electrolytic cell is what? Electrolytic cell is a setup in which electrolysis takes place. It means in which the electricity go and it break down the electrolytes. So let's see what are the parts here. So always remember, in electrolysis there are you can say three parts. So first you have a battery. Okay, so first part is a battery. The second part we have electrode. Okay, there are two electrode, cathode and anode. So this is the second component. And the third component what we have here is electrolyte. So this is the third component we have. We'll just discuss in a couple of minutes what is the each of these means. So you know, battery, why we use a battery? Battery is use a power source. Okay, and here it acts as an electron pump which draw the electron away from the anode. Okay, so when it draw the electron away from the anode, as you can see here, this is the anode, it draw the electron away from the anode. So what will happen naturally? The electron will go from here, so it will become a positive charge comparatively. So when always we write it in comparative way, so this will become a positively charged. And this electron which is going away from the electron, it enters the positive terminal of the battery and pumped out of the negative terminal of this battery. So electron is going here, positive terminal to and come to negative terminal. These electrons are supplied to which part? Cathode. Okay, which is here, and that's why cathode is a negatively charged. So there is a question that the cathode is a negative electrode. Why? Because it is attached to the negative terminal of the battery. Anode is a positive. Why? Because it is attached to the positive part of the battery. Okay, and the battery, what it is doing, it's basically acting as an electron pump which drawing the electron away from the anode. That's why it is the positive parts. I hope this part is clear, that what is the function of battery now. Okay, so it's behave like electron pump. Now let's talk about the electrode. Just now we have discussed electrode. Okay, are of two types, very important. Electrodes are two types, the cathode and anode. Just now what we discussed, anode will act like a positive because it has less electron. Cathode will behave like a negative electron because it has comparatively more electron. Okay, so electrode is the only one, remember, which conduct electricity. Remember, this is a battery and after that you have electrode and there's a solution. So what is electrode? Electrode is only one which conduct electricity, and we use different electrodes, you know, based on the requirement what we have. We use inert electrode which don't react with electrolyte. We use the electrode which is can be a metal which can react with the electrolyte. So it depends on what requirement we are using. So electrode connected to the, what is this anode? This electrode is connected to the positive terminal of the battery. Positive terminal of battery. And what is the negative electrode? This is called a negative electron because it is connected to the negative terminal of the battery. Connected to negative terminal of battery. Okay, so now what we have finished? We have finished what is the function of battery, component 1, electrode, and now we are going to talk about what is electrolytes. Okay, so basically electrolyte is the solution which is going to break down. So it should be some kind of, you know, there should be some ionic form. So electrolytes conduct electricity and they are the free moving ions, you know, whatever you will use here, the ions should be free moving so that it can flow, the electricity can flow here. So to flow that, either you should use the molten stage, very important, or you should use aqueous state. What is aqueous state? Where you dissolve the solution as ionic compound so that they can separate into the ions, and then it will decompose into the cations and the anions. Okay, so for example, if I'll use the sodium chloride as a electrolyte here, so there will be two kind of ions, right? It will form Na plus, which is cation, and Cl minus. So which is the negative here ions, it will attract obviously to the positive electrode, which is anode, right? So and cathode, cation will attract to the positive, the negative electrode will attract the positive, which is the cation sodium ion here. So I hope this part is clear here, that what are the parts of electrolysis. So there are three parts: battery, electrodes and electrolytes. I hope this part is clear. So I'm moving now that, okay, I know the component, but how does it work? How electrolysis working? So here, remember, there are multiple circuits. So first is the external circuit, so we have to understand in a break. So basically, if you think, there are three things happening. One is happening at external, means battery. Second is as happening as the electrode. And the third part happening within the electrolytes. So let's understand one by one in a detail. In external circuit, what is happening? So during electrolysis, what happened? Electron flow from positive terminal or to the negative terminal of battery. Just now we have discussed that it is electron is going from this side to this side. Okay, so this is one circuit. Now at cathode, what happened? At cathode, so the cathode, you know, just now we have discussed, is a negative electrode, right? So it will, because it has extra electron now, so it will pull the cations. So cation will move there to the cathode. And cation means what? Suppose the sodium ion means a positive charge. So it has deficiency of electron. So it is going to take electron from the cathode and it is going to discharge, means it will form the sodium ion. Sorry, sodium metal itself. So here what is happening? Reduction is happening. What is reduction? Reduction is basically gain of electron. There are multiple definition. Gain of electron, decrease in oxidation state, combination with hydrogen, loss of oxygen. So there are four definition of reduction. So here which one is matching? Matching is that the sodium ion went, the cation go there and they take the electron and discharge over there. Now what happened at the anode, which is a positive electrode here? Why positive? Because electron is going away, so it has less electron. So here, obviously, if it is a positive, it will pull the anion, which is the negative ions. So anion, anode, It's very similar words. Always remember in terms of at least the terminology. So anions give up the electron. Why it will give up? Because you will always have extra, like chloride ion, it have extra electron, so it will give the electron, and then what happen? It will form the chlorine gas, right? So when the chlorine will be form, as you can see here, what is happening? Oxidation state minus become plus. So here there is increase in oxidation state, so that's why they call oxidation. So oxidation happening at the anode. So we have finished two circuit. Now the third is what is happening within the electrolyte. Just now we have discussed electrolytes will release the ions. So here what happened during electrolysis, the breakdown of this solution, the flow of ions towards the electrode constitute the flow of electric current, right? Electric current is basically continuation of the flow of ions, flow of electrons. So here the ions is involved in this process, okay, which is moving from one end to another, and they are involved. So what is electrolysis? Is it clear? I hope that here electrical energy in this process, what is happening? Just with this example, as you can see here, electrical energy is converted into what? Chemical energy. Yes, what does it mean? That as you can see here, the chemical reaction is happening. What is this reaction happening? Called redox. Means one end you have oxidation, one end you have other reduction. So this is the chemical energy changes, and it will give you the redox reaction. So I hope this part is clear now. So in next video, I'm going to talk about, just now we have discussed what happening to the ions. So cation, which is the positive ions, receive the electron at the negatively charged ion, which is the cathode. So see the linkage, cathode, cation. Cathode is a negative electrode, so it will pull the positive ions, right? And what will happen? It will become the atomic form. So that is called discharge. So now it will be no longer ionic form. And cathode, since they have less electron, it will take the electron from the cathode. At the anode, which was the positive, it means it has less electron. Here anion will go and lose the electron and become like atoms or molecules. And this process where ion becomes atoms or molecule is called discharged. So for example, when chlorine will become chloride ion, become chlorine gas, you will say that it is discharged, okay, discharged. So it has loses the electron. There is one more terminology I thought I should discuss with you, that what is the meaning of non-electrolyte. As the name suggests, non means not. So these are the substances which do not conduct electricity under any condition. For example, all the covalent compound like sugar, distilled water. Why distilled water? Remember, whatever species the water, you know, it's electrolysis because they are ionic in the nature, because they have some ions, you know, fluoride ion, chloride ion, or some other thing, okay, and all the organic compound like ethanol. So this is the first part. There are some other information which also I thought I should discuss with you, that they are different electrodes what you can use, okay. You can use either the element, okay, or you can use. So what is the difference between the elements, you know, what we use for the electrical conduction, or when you use the electrolytes? So what is the difference is there? So as you can see that metal have the free electron, so method of conduction in the metal will be the flow of electron from the one end to conductor to another end. However, in electrolytic conduction, what is happening? Electricity is conducted by the movement of positive ion and negative ion across the molten or aqueous electrolytes. So obviously in the metal there will be electron, but in electrolytic what will happen? Ions will be here. So what is the effect of conduction here? Here the metal or graphite will remain chemically unchanged because just current flow through them. And here what is happening in this process? Electrolytes decomposed, okay. So if this is sodium ion chlorine, it will become sodium ion and chloride ion. And the new substance, you know, can form based on what is discharged, what is not. And I hope this is part clear now. So till now what we have discussed? We have discussed point number one, that electrolysis is the process using electricity to break down or decompose a compound. It takes place in a cell called electrolytic cells, which have three important part: battery, electrodes and electrolytes. What are electrolytes? Electrolytes are compound that conduct electricity in molten state or in aqueous state. What is cathode? It's a negative charge electrode where cation will go and discharge. Anode is a positively charged electrode, that's why anion will go and discharge. So this is basically a total redox reaction takes place in the electrode during electrolysis, where oxidation occurs at anode, very important point, where the oxidation occurs at anode, where the reduction happen at cathode. Whenever you have doubt, you always write something, okay, that okay, cation will go at the cathode and discharge. It means cation, sodium ion will become sodium metal, and this is called reduction. So this is how you can link this process. Now this is your homework. So I hope if you understood this tutorial, you can definitely solve this question. And let me know in comment box, like question number one. What is this question number? Liquid hydrogen chloride is not electrolyte, but an aqueous sodium hydroxide is that. So remember, you have learned in ionic compound chapter as well, ionic and covalent bonding. So please try to solve this question based on this tutorial and what others thing you know. So let me know how this video fine. So let me let's share with other students also if you think it's a good and useful. If you like it, please subscribe my channel so I can make more video for you. And finally, thank you so much.